much more than tongue can tell. There are wonders in your ways, Lord. Let me learn to praise you well.
Praise you well.
Praise you well. I've got to praise you well. The goodness you shine.
Praise the Lord, everybody. God is so good, and truly the Lord's mercy, it endures until the end. I want to talk to you today about our victory in Christ Jesus. Let us pray. Father, let the anointing flow, I pray, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I want to begin reading in your hearing from Romans, the 8th chapter, verse 28. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. We can bless God today that all things, he's able to turn all things around for good. Now, we know that all things that come our way are not good. You know, the death of someone we might consider is not good, but God can even use that. Maybe the person was suffering, or maybe, you know, there are some things going on that only God knows. So we have to trust God in all things, to know that whatever comes our way, because we belong to him and we know that God loves us, we have to trust that whatever comes our way, God can turn that thing and work it for good, you know, for those who are called according to his purpose. Hallelujah. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son. We can bless God today because he has called each and every one of us. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. God's desire is that he would not that any should perish, but that all should come to salvation knowledge. God has made a way for everyone that desires, everyone that would say yes to the call, everyone that would, you know, yield to his calling, yield to the Spirit, and, you know, confess that they are sinners, and confess that they need God, and confess that Jesus is Lord, and confess that he died and he was buried and he rose from the grave. God says, hallelujah, that you can be welcomed into his kingdom, and you can be transformed, hallelujah, conformed to the image of his son. Begin to act like Jesus, begin to talk like Jesus, begin to do the things that Jesus did when he walked on this earth. Hallelujah, that we might be like his son. That's what God is looking for. What did you do with Jesus? What did you do? Whose life did you affect? Hallelujah. Who did you tell about Jesus? Hallelujah. Moreover, verse 30 says, whom he predestined, these he also called. Whom he called, these he also justified. You know, just as we had never sinned. See, Jesus, the blood that he shed, took away and paid the price for our sins. All we did was said yes. We said yes to what God, the grace that God had given unto us. And it says, and whom he justified, these he also glorified. See, now that we are part of the kingdom of God, we have been elevated. Hallelujah. And as the Amplified Bible says, you know, raised to heavenly dignity. We're part of a new kingdom. We represent the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He shared this with us. We are to be the most grateful people. We are the ones that should give God most praise because he took broken lives. Most of us who, you know, would be honest, our lives were full of sin at one point. And God called us out of darkness into a marvelous light and gave us an inheritance, made us joint heirs with his only begotten son, Jesus. Oh, that's reason to give him praise. That's reason to exalt him. That's reason not to worry about what people think when you are in church and you're giving God praise. Don't worry about them. They don't know what God has delivered you from. They don't know what God has created you to be. And now you're walking into the manifestation of what God created you to be. Hallelujah. Don't worry about what people think about you or what they say. You walk in that calling. You walk in that anointing. Hallelujah. Because Jesus paid the price for that. Jesus suffered and hung on the cross so that we might be free, so that we can be what God created us to be. Hallelujah. So that's reason to praise God for the elevation that he has given all of his children. And again, as the Amplified Bible says, raised to heavenly dignity. Glory be to God. We're part of a new kingdom. Verse 31, and I'll conclude with this verse. What then shall we say to these things? Hallelujah. These marvelous things, these wonderful things, these glorious things, you know, being set free, being freed from sin, being part of the kingdom of God, being able to go before the great God, the eternal God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Hallelujah. The God that formed men from the dust of the ground, the God that spoke this world into existence, the God that can do all things, the God that declares nothing is impossible for him, the God that is declared he will never leave us nor forsake us. This God we have access to because our great high priest Jesus went once before. Hallelujah. And now the veil has been rent and we can go before our heavenly Father and cry, Abba Father. Hallelujah. He is now our very own and we are his children of God. What then shall we say to these things? Hallelujah. So if God has done all of this magnificent things for us, then it says in the scripture, if God is for us, who can be against us? Who can reverse what God has done? Hallelujah. Who can stop what God is doing? And who can prevent his ultimate plan that he has in the future? No one can. Hallelujah. God is great and he is unstoppable. And I want you to know again tonight that he loves his people. Want to close one of my videos without giving someone the opportunity to give their life to the Lord. You know, in the days and the hours and the time that we are living in now, it demands that you know who you are, who you belong to, and where you are going. And so I want to give you the opportunity to give your life to the Lord. If you have not heard the story, the Bible declares that we were all born sinners. It says over in the book of Romans, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. And that transpired back in the book of Genesis where Adam disobeyed God. And because of Adam's disobedience, sin and death entered into the world. And so Jesus, who was God's sacrificial lamb, because a price had to be paid for the sins of the world. So God sent In John 3:16, he says, "For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." So that's what I want to give you the opportunity to do today, to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, to wash away all of your sins. Romans 10:9 says, "If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, the Bible says you shall be saved." Romans 10:13 says, "If you call on the name of the Lord, he will save you." So just repeat this prayer after me. Also, if you have walked away from the Lord, come on back home. Just say, "Lord, I confess that I am a sinner. I'm sorry for the wrong that I have done. Please forgive me. I invite you to come into my heart and be my Lord and my Savior. I denounce Satan. I declare that Jesus is Lord. I believe that he died, that he was buried, and that he rose again. And now that I am your child, please fill me with your precious Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen." If you have said that prayer, God bless you. Welcome to the family of God. Know today, all of heaven is rejoicing because you have chosen to make Jesus your personal Lord and Savior. Welcome again to the family of God.